Even me to go to see a doctor, it takes me, I have to be really, really, really sick to go to see a doctor because I don't really like all this environment, I don't know. But it's not about me, really.
Every morning for the past 2 years, Isabel confronts this fear to visit Sayashka, Rwanda's largest public hospital. For two hectic hours, she'll distribute bread and soup to feed hundreds of patients.
S'il y a des cas plus graves à la salle 1, on commence à la salle 8. Si on est à la salle 8, on commence par la salle 8. Donc c'est au jour le jour pour que quand on arrive au bout de la ligne, ceux qui souffrent plus, c'est quelque chose à manger. Là maintenant, on avait à peu près 40 litres de soupe. Mais cette fois-ci, on n'a pas eu de lait parce qu'il y a eu un problème avec les vaches. Donc pas de lait. On fait des grosses assiettes pour que les gens puissent partager. C'est pour ça que quand on te donne beaucoup. Souvent en urgence, tu te retrouves que les gens arrivent sans rien. Donc sans assiette, sans rien, sans papier hygiénique, sans colgate, sans brosse à dents. Si tu n'as pas de famille à Kigali et que personne ne vient te nourrir, personne ne viendra te voir pour t'apporter à manger. Tu dois avoir quelqu'un basé à Kigali qui a une cuisine à Kigali et qui lui va venir. Parce que même quand tu as garde malade, il n'a pas une cuisine pour cuisiner tous les jours. Donc il se retrouve dans la même galère que toi. Vous devez tous les deux en fait chercher à manger. Quand tu vois quelqu'un par jour, une fois par jour, et que vous voyez, même si je ne dis pas qu'en fait j'ai le temps de discuter plus de 5 minutes, 10 minutes, mais c'est un visage familier.
Ah, ok. Je suis venu à la maison.
Put her on the list to receive porridge and soup. And she has tubes, so it really needed to be dilué.
Bitewe no kuvuga abaganga barebye basanga ari yenda ari ngombwa kugira ngo ngende ngereyo bareba uko bimeze hari igihe burya abantu ntago bahuza ati kimwe hari igihe umwe abarushije undi ubushobozi yenda burenzeho ubwo nibo bakumva ko bashobora kugerayo bagasanga hari ubarushije ububasha kuba yakurikirana uko imbere mu mubiri hameze ku buryo nataha nanjye nishimye numva ko nkize buri rugo.
Des fois, il y a des femmes qui arrivent là, elles ont 3 enfants. Donc, il y a un enfant qui est malade, mais comme elle n'a pas de bonne ou de boy pour la maison, qui va garder les autres enfants, elle n'a pas de mari, elle emmène les deux autres. Qu'est-ce que tu veux voir? Tu vois, de toute façon, ces enfants qui sont là toute la journée et qui non plus ne mangent pas. Et c'est difficile, tu vas en nourrir un et laisser les deux autres. Non. Donc, c'est une vie. Dans l'hôpital, il y a toute une vie et tous des gens, c'est toute une société qui est là-dedans, et tu ne peux pas se diviser. Et voilà quand tu as appris à mourir au phtalmologie.
A lot of admissions in Rwanda are related to nutritional deficiency. I mean, you don't go into Sayashka and think, gosh, obesity is a big problem in Rwanda. It is critical that hospitals like Sayashka have people supporting feeding patients in-house. Now, it is absurd to me that we haven't figured this out. I'm not talking about in Rwanda, I'm talking about all these hospitals across the world, the idea that the patients can bring in their family members bring in the food, that's not a good idea. I just said that a number of these patients are admitted because of some contribution of poor nutritional status. So to bring their female relative, because it's usually a mother or a sister or a child, a daughter, to bring their female relative away from the family to start cooking in some other city or town is not a good plan.
Rwanda's healthcare policy is unique among developing countries. 96% of Rwandans have a mutuelle, or public health insurance, but none of them are fed during their stay in hospitals because the government believes patients must pay for their own food.
I prefer that across each and every health center, there is little business that are growing that provide food to people who are hospitalized against a certain cost. This is sustainability. It provides economic growth around the hospital and assure also the services. Charity, nothing is there for sustainability and development.
Sayeshka is home to nearly 1,000 patients. Because they are allowed to move around hospital grounds, they quickly get to meet one another and spend most of their day socializing. Remarkably, they recreate the traditional family structure they knew outside of Sayeshka and become brothers and sisters. They even divide up household chores, such as doing laundry and cleaning the dishes.
Minimize the damage.
Bosco is the oldest patient in the world, so you just go there, yeah, Bosco, do you know the new baby, She said, yeah, she's right there, this sign, the situation is that. Whatever I was lost, I just asked Bosco. He's helpful. Mama Zuzu were talking about him, because I think that she knew him before I came to the hospital. And she said, you know what, I have that guy, I have to show you. His situation is really complicated. It's maybe because of the blessure qu'il a. Because as you can see, he had many surgeries.
Cyangwa se bakarisatura bagakuramo cya gisasu umusukura bakawumaramo imbere bagasigamo imiti igufa bakongera bakarifunga.
Bosco helps patients settle into their new home and pays special attention to those who stay there alone. Today he looks after Mandela, a 20-year-old orphan who is new to Kigali.
Naramwe byose twabanye neza mu burwayi yari afite bwose twabaye abarwayi bumvikana bega bahuje ibibazo muri make nakababara.
That is okay pour him. C'est ça sa maladie. He's waiting for a surgery for his leg. It's planned for January, but it's been a month that he's waiting for that surgery. Even though that the mutual pays for all his bills, he can't leave the hospital because he don't have the money to take the bus to go back. So he can't really, you know, go around and just chill out. The hospital is the only thing that he know. Now that he know that we are here, it's maybe easier for him to know that, okay, tomorrow they're gonna come, I will have my daily meal. I used to go and see them and just cry. And then I realized that, my parents have done, yeah, you can, you know, if I cry and I don't help you, who cares? And normally, you know, you cry and people are just like cheering you up. And you're supposed to be the one cheering them up.
Suddenly, Isabel gets a worrying call from Bosco about one of Sayeshka's youngest patients.
The boy that I was looking for is now in intensive care. Maybe because he didn't wake, so I'll go there to look for him. I think he's stable. He was crying, so I said, how are you? He said, I'm fine. So I really don't want, like, tomorrow I will talk to him. Maybe he'll be more willing to talk. But what I know is that he has mutual because he's one of the first Christians. Because if he doesn't, it's even hard to help him. the thing that they, this thing, they have to examine it, the tumor now, they have to examine it to King Faisal and to see if the baby will need any other treatment, if he will need to be transferred. But for now, we don't know. We were talking just about food because today we didn't find, Mama Zuzu probably didn't find him, so I was telling him tomorrow to go to the emergency. But now that we know that he's in intensive care, because sometimes when you move, we can't know where you are.
Sylvani is getting transferred to King Faisal Hospital. Using technology unavailable at Sayesh Kaa, doctors will place a camera down her throat to see if her wounds are healing. Her mutuelle is paying the cost of the entire procedure, as well as the transfer. Isabel has been waiting for this moment for a long time.
It's maybe because she's a little bit old. So you see, I don't know. Quand tu es d'une personne plus âgée, c'est comme une maman, une grand-mère. In the Rwandese culture, every mom can be your mom. So it's not like my mom, but I'm taking her for mom.
Inside, King Faisal Hospital looks nothing like Sayesh Kaa. Thanks to a large Saudi development fund, it has invested in specialized care, brand new equipment, and high sanitary standards. Back at Sayesh Kaa, everyone seems to be in a particularly good mood this morning. Eric, the prankster of the group, gives Mandela a hand in striking up a conversation with a girl that he likes. Cupid knows he has hit his target, and the intervention is a resounding success. Others wait for lunchtime by playing Iturufu, a local version of the popular war card game. Isabel arrives a little later today from church, the very place where it all began for her in Solid Africa.
Moi, j'avais l'habitude de prier avec maman Zouzou et d'autres dames. Je venais de Bruxelles, ça faisait un mois que j'étais rentrée, et je priais comme une enfant gâtée, vraiment. Je prie pour les malades, je prie pour les orphelins, je prie pour tous les gens qui ont mal et qu'on sort. Et un jour, elle m'a dit, mais tu vois, c'est facile. Tu pries, mais tes prières sont vides. Parce que si un jour tu te déplaces pas, tu vois, là, tu pries pour les malades, mais est-ce que t'as même jamais été un jour voir un malade et savoir ce qu'il a pour savoir. Je dis non, elle me dit mais viens avec moi. Et moi j'ai pris ça comme un défi. J'ai fait genre quoi, je suis pas capable d'aller à l'hôpital et de voir des gens malades et de prier pour eux. Et voilà. Et quand je suis venue ici, c'était juste, ça a tout changé.
Born into a wealthy family, Isabel moved to Belgium for her studies and could have chosen any career path. Instead, she does what makes her happiest in life.
Even when I'm singing, I take one song that I know, you know, it's like Saga Africa, and I put Solid Africa instead. And it's like Solid Africa. Yeah, but then la suite ne va pas, because it's the ambiance de l'amour, but it doesn't fit with our thing. Huh? But we need a theme. I need Jay-Z to write a song.
Katubereke kiranyo kipa mu buzima busanzwe bituma mbega muri make ntacyo nkenera nanyo mfite icyo gihumbi mbaye nabyo biramfasha n'umwe bo ubundi kugira ngo mbitangire ni sosiyali wabinyigishije kumwe aba sosiyali batwigisha imyuga runaka ariko maze kubimenya byaramfashije kuko niyo nakoze nk'iryo Helena harigurisha icyo cy'atanu kiranyo kipa mu buzima busanzwe.
On her way to the car, Isabel is approached by a woman suffering from gastroschisis. Her intestines lay outside her body and she keeps them supported with a green and yellow wrapper. She hasn't eaten in a day and Isabel will once again try to convince her to drink some soup.
And she doesn't like to eat. Donc, dans la supplée, non, elle n'aime pas manger, elle est malade, donc elle n'a pas envie de manger. Souvent, quand on est malade, on n'a pas. Donc, il faut en plus de ça supplier.
In those cases, she turns to patients that trust her to win over the others. Sylvanie is back after an exhausting day. And while she didn't have to pay for today's procedure, she still hasn't eaten any food. So she heads straight for Salit's office. But she'll have to wait because of an all too familiar sight. A mother breaking down as she learns about the death of her child.
It doesn't get easier, mais comme on dit, ça peut pas, on ne peut pas empêcher les gens de mourir. Donc il y a des gens qui viennent ici, comme je vous dis, la plupart ont vraiment des graves maladies. Et c'est... Je crois qu'il faut, à un moment donné, il faut apprendre à dealer avec la mort. Et moi, je n'ai pas peur de la mort. Je me dis, de toute façon, on est tous appelés à mourir un jour ou l'autre. Mais juste, il faut qu'on soit sûr que ce n'est pas une question, que la personne n'est pas morte, parce que ça fait 4 jours ou 5 jours qu'il n'a pas mangé, même au-delà de sa maladie. Moi, c'est ça qui me ferait... C'est ça qui m'inquiète le plus. Mais au-delà de savoir qu'une personne meurt, ça, j'y peux rien. Les gens mourront avant, après moi, moi compris. Mais c'est juste être sûr que ce soit la maladie qui les emporte, mais pas parce qu'on n'a pas pu faire quelque chose en plus. Voilà.
Isabelle is in for more bad news. The financial numbers for the end of December reveal a potentially devastating blow to the organization. With 3 months to go, the entire annual budget has already been spent.
Normally our budget should be for 1 year 24 million, because it's normally 2 million per month. So we didn't do as good as I thought. On dit que ça va tenir une semaine, et ça sans le budget de se dire la soupe. Il faut que je rappelle David pour le budget de la soupe, mais on est début janvier. Donc c'est dire que là maintenant, il faut qu'on mette les Manuela, les équipes qui s'occupent de Donner Management doivent mettre une pression à nos contributeurs, les sponsors et de voir que vraiment l'argent rentre cette première semaine.
I think a lot of NGOs, small NGOs, don't really have a chance to have access to the resources they need to grow and do a better job.
Isabel calls for a meeting with Salit members to find a long-term solution. Most donations come from wealthy family members and friends who support her cause, but now she is forced to find a more stable source of income.
Nonprofit is not sustainable because there is always somebody who pays for it. The day people are not paying for it, it's not sustainable.
I'm here to ask for sponsor for the soup. I'm asking for 350,000. Ça va, j'étais seule. Désolée d'être en retard. Non, je sais, mais après, mais il me reste là, on est le 27, et qu'après cette semaine, donc à partir de jeudi, il n'y aura plus d'argent pour faire de la soupe. Donc c'est-à-dire que même si j'arrive à trouver des membres, des cotisations, je ne pourrais tenir qu'une semaine, vu que c'est à peu près 80 000 par semaine, 81 770. Donc, et je sais que je ne peux pas trouver les 350 000 pour tout un mois. Donc ce qui serait génial, c'est que vraiment en janvier, si vous puissiez nous aider.
On peut décider par exemple de donner un certain montant chaque mois.
Oui, oui. Non, bien sûr. Même si ce n'est pas tout le montant, on peut chercher alors maintenant d'autres partenaires. C'est beaucoup plus facile en disant, OK, on a peut-être déjà 150 000 ou 200 000 de Génimaux. On a besoin de temps en fait pour pouvoir réaliser ça. Donc, c'est autant que vous pouvez donner. If you sign a contract saying I will give you 1%, 2% of my budget, of my profits every month, then you can be sure to have that money.
Et chaque personne a une version différente.
People are willing to give. I think you have to dare to ask. Tonight I'm going to pray so that they can really take care of the whole the whole budget, because otherwise, ça va nous retarder. Because then we have to wait to search for another sponsor, so that we can have the soup that we want.
Meanwhile, another Salit member is on his way out of the city to collect a monthly food donation and ease the current situation.
We're going to see the person who agreed to give us meat, chicken actually, from the farm. So we're going to the farm.
Ihangane abantu waje kudufirima arakantu tushaka kumenyesha abantu.
Chicken is special to them because some of the time you hear people telling you that they never even have had chicken for a long time, even when they are not sick. So giving them chicken is even way special than giving them meat. They electrocute it and then they pass it through the guillotine there. So this is what they are giving us for the sick. We're gonna do the operation of taking them. Let's say like 50 packets, which we hope that this will feed up to 500 people. I mean, like, and the section. By going on, all our partner, we need to like uplift them. Yeah, we cannot just come here, take the chicken, and go. Huh? That's why, in all our activity, we want our partner to be in there, to be involved. So when we are doing something, we call them, we tell them to bring their logos. If we have like an event, and our website is one of the places where we can showcase our partner. So we want also them to get more business working with us.
I think Rwanda is probably the leader of the pack in the alternative approach, that all of the NGOs have to accord their plans with local partners and also have to show that they're helping to build local capacity.
It's New Year's Day, and Bosco celebrates the only way he knows how, by inviting patients to a friendly competition of checkers.
How do I describe him? I think he's the strongest man that I ever know. Like, psychologically. For me, you know, to stay on the same place 9 years, it feels like prison. You know, you can't go out, and he always have that smile. If he doesn't complain, how come half of us pass your time to plan for how we want to know?
No, I can't guess.
Hey.
He's so sweet and he talks, I don't know. He has that kindness. And I think that is the most, the thing that I like the most. It's the kindness that he has.
It's a special day for Salit Africa and the patients here at Sayeshka. For many, this will be the best meal of the year. Buckets of food are a rare sight for these patients. The chicken donated earlier is cooked and added to plates of rice and beans. The familiar faces are here, but happy to let others go first. And when needed, they help them with nutritional tips. The food is attracting a lot of attention, and Salit is struggling to keep up with the demand. Isabel quickly finds herself scraping the bottom of the rice bucket, and her biggest fear becomes reality.
No, because it's not enough. Now they know that they notice. Don't have rice, don't have potato, just have beans and meat. At some point, we need to find a solution. We don't have enough food. We don't. Normally, I try to, you know, between giving the rice and stuff, sometimes it stops you, say, you know what? No. Just calm down.
Okay. We don't have even the facilities to cook more. Yeah, we don't have funds. We don't have enough money.
I don't worry. Because for me, maybe because I believe her, I know that God worries more than me. So he will find the solution at one point. And I just have to think and to be patient and just keep faith and not be, you know, be desperate and think that it's over. And
Isabel gets a friendly reminder of why she comes back every day. A little boy in blue with the strength to push his friend is Alexei, who has made a remarkable recovery.
I just love kids, just, I don't know. Yeah, it's maybe because, you know, kids are just amazing. You don't really what they think about the world, you don't really what, I don't know, they're just so innocent and whatever, and it's so easy to talk with them. Because whatever they want to ask, they're going to ask. Whatever they think, they're going to say.
Isabel is able to smile and say goodbye to Alexei. But stories don't always end well at Sayeshka.
Il va pas bien, son truc a explosé sur le dos. Son... Là, on l'a opéré avant. Et au dos aussi, il a un nouveau truc, sa jambe ne va toujours pas. Ce qui fait qu'il n'en peut plus, lui, maintenant. Il en est au point de juste vouloir rentrer. Mais s'il rentre, qu'il n'est pas soigné, de toute façon. Donc, quand je vois quelqu'un qui pleure, je pleure aussi. C'est pas... Non, donc là, on va essayer de...
At some point of your life, you found your place. I think it's my place to help those who can't help themselves. Even me to go to see a doctor, it takes me, I have to be really, really, really sick to go to see a doctor because I don't really like all this environment, I don't know. But it's not about me, really. You know, what I do, somebody else can do it. It's even more than selfish to say, you know, I don't want to go to help them because I don't like the place where they are. Thank you.